أو ما من عام بأقل مطرا من عام، ولكن الله يصرف.
Okay, عبد الرحمن.
Dr. Zahul, we hear about certain ages where some places were more rainy than others. I mean, now if you go to Europe, you will notice that it's raining all the time. Was there a point when Egypt was as green as Europe and was raining all the time like this?
So the question is that in Europe you'll find rain most of the time of the year.
Yes.
And actually most of the time of the day.
Yes.
So is there a reason of having like countries like Egypt with less amounts of rain and less greenery areas like Europe?
Yes.
He's not envying Europe or anything. Yes. So he's just
No. Just actually Allah through his wisdom distributes the rain according to his own plan. He can give a country lots of rain and deprive another country from rain. And this must have reason with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the people are good and committed to the divine guidance and not betraying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah can give them. If the people know the true religion and they try to drift away from it and depart from the divine guidance, of course Allah will punish them as a way of awakening them, as a way of reminding them. But things do not remain constant. You see, Europe less than 2 million years ago was glaciated in the last great ice age. And the ice killed everything, killed the plants, killed the animals, and humans tried to migrate to different areas. Now Europe is green. We are going towards another phase of glaciation. And if this phase begins, North America and North Europe will be glaciated. And the desert area extending from Mauritania in the west to Afghanistan in the east will be enjoying heavy rain. And most of the dry valleys in these deserts will be flowing rivers. And most of the arid areas will be covered by plantation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is distributing his bounties according to his own will and according to his own knowledge and according to his own wisdom.
So we have something like a weather rotation cycle.
Yes.
But this, of course, takes thousands of years.
But it's not random and it's not at a fixed plan. It goes with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
SubhanAllah. But this triggers in my mind the question of climate change.
Yes.
Will climate change really change the weather, or is just the rotation cycle of weather?
You see, climate change, that's true.
By pollution or?
We have a system that tailored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the change of climate. But the interference of man can sometimes disrupt this plan. And disrupting it, Allah leaves it to man as a source of punishment. And that's why Allah says, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس ليذيقهم بعض الذي عملوا لعلهم يرجعون. So ill doings will flood everywhere. As we see it these days, on land and sea. And land also includes the atmosphere above the land. And the sea includes the atmosphere above the sea. So in every environment, these ill doings will cause man to suffer. And this suffering is a way of awakening man. لعلهم يرجعون. So probably they may return back to their creator.
It will expedite the process of weather changing.
It will disrupt it. It will not expedite it. It will disturb it. Nowadays we have areas that never had rain. These areas are currently suffering flooding. We had areas that had regular rain. And nowadays they are suffering from aridity. Mm. And so on. But you see, if there is a normal change in the climatic conditions, it corrects itself by itself. But if it is caused by human intrusion, Allah leaves it to man.
Yes.
You see? Leaves it to man.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, I have a question regarding we were discussing the Earth as a level surface, although it's not really uniform. Why is Allah mentioning the perfection of the sky, and we have the Earth which we are living on, not really uniform and not really perfect as the sky?
You see, everybody in the sky is worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in great obedience and submitting to the will of Allah in great obedience. Mm-hmm. Only on earth Allah has created a creation with a free will.
Yes.
And for human beings and jinn.
Yes.
We are free-willed beings, and that's why Allah has brought us here to be tested. And mm-hmm. He's leaving us, you see, either we can correct our own mistakes or suffer by it.
Mm-hmm.
So here we are suffering from the ill
from
deeds of
mistakes.
Human beings and jinn.
Okay, and the second question is about earthquakes.
Yes.
The verse says al-ard firashan, and but at the same time we find earthquakes that actually has some sort of destructions to many homes and many lives. What is the scientific reason behind the earthquakes, and how do you link it to this verse?
You see, there is a great difference between the description of the earth as firash.
Yes.
As a low-lying area that is easily accessible to man and
yes.
is making life easy for man. This is the meaning of Russian, you see.
Yes.
But earthquakes come from the movement of the lithospheric plates, the plates that constitute the outer rocky cover of the earth, move either away from each other or collide with each other, towards each other, until they collide. As a result of that collision, the friction resulting from that collision creates earthquakes.
Yes.
I was asked after the tsunami event, what do you think of what happened? I said, this is one of the soldiers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which Allah sends as a means of punishment to ill-doers, as a means of testing for good people, and as a reminder for those who will survive that event. And then secularists started screaming at me, how come you say this? We know the mechanism of an earthquake 100%. Why refer it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? But if you read in the Quran, you will see clearly that there is no punishment that takes place on the surface of that planet without an ill doer. And there is no reward without a good doer. And Quran spells that beautifully. And yes. in Surah Al-Nahl, we find a Quranic description of how an earthquake can take place. And it shows clearly this is a sheer result of ill-doers and a test for good ones.
Exactly. So it could be a punishment, and also it could be a test.
A test, a trial, yes.
Yes.
And the Prophet was asked, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, أَنَهْلَكُ وَفِيْنَ الصَّالِحُونَ Could we really be destroyed? And we have some pious people. I said, yes. People will be resurrected, each with his own intention and his own will.
Okay, one final question. It's about the last verse, which is, وَالْأَرْضُ فَرَشْنَاهَا فَنِعْمَ الْمَاهِدُونَ
Now,
so we need to know more about فَنِعْمَ الْمَاهِدُونَ.
Because if you can calculate the amount of energy that was exerted to penetrate the surface of the earth, all the wealth of the wealthy people and the non-wealthy people, all the wealth of the human beings
yes.
will not be enough to pay for it.
Yes.
The amount of energy executed to level the surface, to cut down valleys, to cut down passageways for canyons, as you mentioned, another place. This is an immense quantity
yes.
of money that nobody can pay. So Allah says, فَنِعْمَ الْمَاهِدُونَ يعني the best of those who could pave ways for you in this life is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Professor Zaghloul Nagar, we thank you very much for being here.
It was
a pleasure to have you here with us at Huda TV. And I also like to thank Abdurrahman and Zabihullah for being here with us. With this, my dear viewers, my dear brothers, we come to the end of this edition of Quran and Science. See you in the next edition. Until then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.